spiritual hypnotherapist and master esthetician Sakura Sutter, your host of Love from the Hip. Welcome to my first broadcast on Alternative Talk 1150. Love from the Hip is unlike anything you've ever heard. This program is all about helping people. I'll talk with people who have used hypnotherapy to improve their lives and get past issues that have thrown up roadblocks. I will also spotlight people from around the world who are helping others in their own unique way. Together, we can all make a difference, and it starts with love. Love from the Hip. So tune in each Wednesday from 2 p.m. to 3 p.m. and join the real, raw, upfront, and honest conversation. Precious gems of wisdom are coming your way. Before we begin, and because it is my first broadcast, I want to tell you a little bit about myself and how this show came into existence. I have been running my own skin and mind clinic, Sakura Skin and Mind, since 2009. Having done skin for 17 years, I started to see a rise in rare skin issues and felt they were related to stress, and so I received my training in hypnotherapy and other modalities and brought those into my practice. It was really making a difference, as I began to realize most of my clients' skin issues were deeply rooted in emotional issues. And then it happened to me. I, too, was diagnosed with a rare skin disorder. I nearly died from it last summer, unable to work, unable to perform day-to-day tasks like walking, eating, and sleeping. The pain became intense. My skin became as thin as tissue and began ripping with the slightest movement, creating huge open wounds. And because of these large open wounds, I was not allowed to go outside and remained indoors for months on end. Although I had been diagnosed 2 years prior, I had it under control until I went through a breakup in January of last year. Even though I had done the breaking off, I still had not gotten over it, and all the years of emotional abuse that I endured finally wanted to be heard. I ended up realizing I, like my clients, also needed hypnotherapy and other mind modalities to help me release this relationship and other toxic relationships from my body in order to finally get better, as well as love myself again. When your body deteriorates, you start to not recognize yourself in the mirror anymore. And when the emotional and physical pain is just too much to bear, you also begin to not love yourself anymore. I did hypnotherapy with a dear colleague weekly, and I started to turn a corner, shocking my family, my friends, and my clients by my recovery from what seemed like imminent death. And so here I am today, sharing with the world that you too can heal yourself, but more so, you too can love yourself, by clearing out all the reasons, programs, thoughts, and relationships that otherwise tell you not to. Ultimately, if you are suffering from pain, illness, phobias, weight issues, addictions, emotional imbalances, anxiety, depression, etc., you are not truly loving yourself, your partner, your children, or your life. Love from the Hip was created to let you know you are not alone. We all do crazy things and act in crazy ways. But we all have a reason for doing so, be it specific to each and every one of us. And we all have a way of correcting or changing it. Love from the Hip was also created to inform you about all the other fascinating things and unique resources that are available to help you along your way. Let's get our collective journey started with today's edition of Love from the Hip. Coming up on the show today, I will be interviewing Peggy Bennett and following up with Alex from her hypnotherapy session she had a few weeks ago, which you can find at lovefromthehip.com. We're going to take a quick break and we'll be right back. Letting my love open the door. Letting my love open the door.
If you're planning on building a home or a major landscaping project, you'll want the team of Stone Resources on your side. Safely, effectively, and correctly working with our unique terrain requires local knowledge and environmental care. For 21 years, Stone Resources has been making sure their customers' biggest investment is on solid ground. Trust your next earth-moving project to Stone Resources. Call 425-754-6792. That's 425-754-6792. Stone Resources. We make the earth move. And remember, if you need dirt or have dirt to get rid of, you can call on us. 425-754-6792.
Your skin is your body's largest organ. Care for it properly, starting with your face. Sakura Skin & Mind offers several clinical facial treatments to help stimulate collagen production, eliminate toxins, boost circulation, and deeply cleanse. See a new you in your mirror. Clinical facials range from $90 and up. Do your face a favor. Sakura Skin & Mind, erasing wrinkles, one clinical facial at a time. Learn more, sakuraskinandmind.com. SAKURA skinandmind.com. Did you know that your skin is your body's first defense against disease and infection? BrioTech knows and has developed their topical skin spray to enhance your skin's natural healing responses and defenses. BrioTech is all about providing its customers products that help promote skin wellness. BrioTech topical skin spray is a light misting spray free of added fragrance, oil, alcohol, and parabens. All this protection without clogging your pores. It's a must addition to your all-around daily skincare regimen. Try BrioTech, a collection of sprayers from 2 ounces to 8 ounces. With this bundle, you can have BrioTech topical skin spray wherever life takes you. All natural and safe to use from head to toe. Irritations, redness, post-procedure sensitivities? Get BrioTech topical skin spray today. Years in the making, doctor recommended, and available through Amazon. Learn more at BrioTechUSA.com. That's BrioTechUSA.com. Support your skin at BrioTechUSA.com. Microneedling is a revolutionary treatment that can help reduce the appearance of acne scars, fine lines, pigmentation, wrinkles, even improve the appearance of stretch marks by stimulating collagen and elastin. Sakura Skin & Mind specializes in this procedure that jumpstarts your body's natural healing process. Sakura Skin & Mind believes in not only keeping the skin up to date with the latest trends in the skincare industry, but also keeping the skin beautiful, fast, pretty, painless, and affordable. Find out more at SakuraSkinAndMind.com. S-A-K-U-R-A SkinAndMind.com.
Alternative Talk 1150, the talk of the sound.
Welcome back. Peggy Bennett is a clarity love coach. She is a podcast host of Real Souls with Peggy Bennett and is founder and chief matchmaker of Straight to the Heart, located in Bellevue. Peggy is a certified matchmaker from the Matchmaking Institute of New York. In addition to being a matchmaker, she is a coach who offers programs to singles on how to manifest your soulmate. Peggy is a native to Seattle who is passionate about bringing quality singles together for love. Say hello, Peggy.
Hi, thanks for having me here.
Thanks for coming. Well, before I get into interviewing Peggy, I wanted to let you know that Peggy is the instigator for my radio show. You see, I met Peggy back in April, and she had asked me if I wanted to come on her podcast, Real Souls with Peggy Bennett, and hypnotize her client, Brianne Rice, from The Bachelor, on helping her to find true love. And so I did, and I loved it. I actually thought, what better way to help others than to broadcast it to the masses? The process I used on her podcast, I called Love from the Hip. I used a method of clearing past relationships and programming from Brianne Rice in order to help her find her ideal man. This process has now become the title of my own show. We all meet people along the way, as Mr. Rogers called them, the helpers, whom really are a gift to our path and help us on our journey. Peggy was just that for me, and so I am grateful to now have her on my show so she can share her gift she is providing to others.
Oh, I'm so touched. Thank you. That's a wonderful story.
No, it's true. So I have to let the listeners know.
Oh, thank you so much.
Yeah, no worries. So tell us, how did you end up becoming a matchmaker?
You know, I think it's in my DNA. Ever since I was in junior high, I remember setting up singles, believe it or not. So it's something that has always come naturally to me. And then I had a long career at Nordstrom. And whether it was fellow employees or customers, as you get to know them, they're always like, gosh, do you happen to know anybody that's single? So I've always just been that girl.
Oh, awesome. So you've always had a lot of single friends then, I take it.
Yes.
that helps a lot.
Or acquaintances, yeah.
That helps a lot. So how long have you had Straight to the Heart?
Coming up on 4 years.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Okay. And what is the age range of the clients you see?
Roughly about 27 to 55.
Okay. Yeah, that's a big, wide range.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And how does your process work?
So it's a traditional style matchmaking. And for those people that don't know what that is.
Like
is,
me, I don't know what that means. So what is that?
So we actually, my client is the actual bachelor. So they sign up for a year membership.
Okay.
And I match them with females that I have vetted through our and join our database of Straight to the Heart. And I offer them unlimited matches throughout the year.
Okay. That's a nice service. And I understand you do coaching as well. So is that part of your service as well?
Or? Yes. Now, with the bachelors and bachelorettes, I do coaching services. With the bachelors who sign up, that is part of their actual membership.
Oh,
they
wow.
can come in. And they do. They uh-huh. ask me all sorts of questions. I'm continuously coaching them, whether mm-hmm. it's maybe a style update to wear
okay.
or
which is definitely needed in Seattle, I must
yes.
say. Sorry.
Women pay attention to men's shoes.
Uh-huh.
So.
Oh, yes. Yes. Yes, we do.
That's an example. Or just any type of coaching. And then I also offer a separate coaching program on how to manifest your soulmate. That's an 8-week course.
Oh, wow.
So that's a separate program that
okay.
I offer.
Is that in a group? Is that done in a group session?
One-on-one.
Okay, individually.
Yes,
okay.
yes.
And so do you find that the men, when they're going on dates, the more dates they have, the more coaching they want?
It's kind of ebbs and flows. It completely depends on the bachelor
okay.
and the success, or sometimes they have frustrations and they
right.
know that they can come to me, or they just don't know. For instance, even like, okay, if a first date went really well,
mm-hmm.
they're asking me, okay, do you have any suggestions on what to do for a second date? You know, they can be just...
yeah, to maintain it, right?
Exactly, exactly.
Okay. So, I mean, do you think then it's important for your clients to get over their past relationships and patterns that they tend to get stuck in?
Absolutely.
Is that part of the coaching that you do?
Absolutely. Okay. When they come in for interviews, the interviews are pretty intensive. And I do ask about their past.
Mm-hmm.
And this is true for both the guys and the gals.
Okay.
And it also ties into, are they really ready? There's some singles that they feel like they are ready,
mm-hmm.
But they actually aren't.
Okay.
So I kind of dive into that. If it's a little too intensive, I would refer them to people like you, right?
Yes, absolutely.
but there are times where I can do on-the-spot coaching, and mm-hmm. I actually give out certain homework assignments.
Oh, okay. Like?
Yeah. Like, there's times where you can feel that they're still not completely over their ex. So mm-hmm. it's kind of like, okay, go home in the privacy of your home and just pick a time where they can write a letter and kind of a letter of closure and thank you so much for the experience you've given me. And I'm the woman I am today mm-hmm. because of this experience. And then it's just kind of a ceremony that they do, ritual.
That's really
yeah.
great.
Yeah.
Because I feel like a lot of... men and women can tend to put their exes, the expectations they had for their ex, on the new person that they meet. So it's like they already set it up to fail without it even having begun. Is that pretty common?
Right. Yeah. 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 I don't know if it's common or not, but you're absolutely right. I have seen that before.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that
yeah.
can be super frustrating.
Right.
Yeah. So do some of your clients come to you with very unrealistic or over-the-top expectations? I mean,
it does happen from time to time. Thankfully, it doesn't happen a lot. But let's just say, for instance, the age factor.
Uh-huh.
With online dating, there's just a specific range, and it can be real black and white, right?
Right.
But with matchmaking, I love the industry I'm in because it's all gray. There is no black and white
okay.
because I'm actually interviewing the gals, right?
Right.
So there are exceptions to the rule where someone, if a gentleman says, oh, I don't want anybody over 5 years older than me, there's always those situations where they're women who look great for their age, right? Mm-hmm. And but you wouldn't necessarily see that online, right?
Right.
So there's always exceptions to the rule, and that's when it's great to be a matchmaker because you can see that potential.
Right, right.
Right. And yeah. The bachelors put trust into me.
Which is
and,
great.
Right.
Yeah.
For me to do my job and just say, got to keep an open mind and let's work together.
Mm-hmm. You're like the wing woman.
Right.
I mean, I imagine it's got to be frustrating too, because I know with my experience of online dating, because it seemed like the only way to date in Seattle, is that you do get put in this bracket. Like if you're out of the age range, it's like they don't even look at you. And then you have to lower and higher your age range that you're looking to meet and in hope. Because you're right. It's a lot of people don't act their age or they don't look their age. And,
right.
And especially women. I mean, I think we tend to take better care of ourselves, you know, physically and internally. And so it's completely different in that way. Yeah.
Right, right, right.
Yeah. So, and saying that too, with like I said, having done online dating because there's the only way to do it here. I'm from Chicago, and Chicago is a much easier place to date. I'm just going to say it. I mean, you can meet
I'm not somebody surprised.
anywhere. I mean, the grocery store. I mean, back in the day, the laundromat. So it didn't matter. But so nowadays, I mean, you hear of this Seattle freeze. I mean, do you think that that's a real thing? Do you think that exists?
You know, I'm a native here, so I don't play into that. But yes, we are, as far as a city, we're not the easiest as far as social. We kind of hibernate in the winter, I have to say.
Yes, we do.
There are cities that are worse than us. But we're guilty of that, I have to admit. I don't like to admit that because it's such a beautiful city. But yes, we are guilty of that. And when I do have my clients come in, that is one of the things I always say is look up away from your phones when you're in line at Starbucks, when you're just doing your thing and grocery store, like you say, and just smile, make eye contact with people. So I really do pass on that message because you never know where you can meet somebody.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
That's a great message.
Yeah. I just ran into a couple who are madly in love and about to get married, and they met each other at the valet waiting for their cars.
Oh, no way.
If you can believe that.
That's amazing. Awesome.
Yeah.
Now tell me he didn't go back and propose there.
No.
Okay. A little more romantic than that. That's good to know. Well, awesome. Well, so, I mean, do you think, though, that age has something to do with it, too, as far as dating? I mean, age and just kind of where we're at as far as being a huge IT industry here. I mean, do you think that has a lot to do with making it harder to date in Seattle?
Yeah, it's definitely in Seattle. People are, quote unquote, plugged in, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I have to say their heads are down in their phones. And so it's all the more reason to have go to a matchmaker for that reason, I think, right? Because there's all the more opportunities to introduce one another together. And but yeah, it definitely has its pros and cons with Seattle. But as a whole, it's surprising. I guess the singles that I attract are really not necessarily they're just really wanting, it's one of my most favorite jobs or parts of my job, I have to say, is when a bachelor comes into my office because they just open their hearts to me.
Oh, great.
Because I ask these real intimate questions and I interview them for a little over an hour intensively. And it's just, it's such an honor to have a bachelor just open up their heart and soul because they're really wanting to find love.
Yeah, and they're really investing their trust in you, which is incredible.
Right, right.
Yeah, wow. So do you encourage them to also kind of go into dating groups or enroll and join as far as like dating group events or singles events, if you will?
I do, like, I do encourage to cast your net wide, okay, in a way. Work with me as a matchmaker. Go online, and I would suggest specific online formats that are good for them depending on their age. Mm-hmm. And yeah, like a meetup, anything like that is great because, again, you just never know where you're going to meet someone.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And there seems to be so many online dating apps these days.
There are.
You have certain that you, I mean, I've heard there's one for farmers even. Like, really?
There is. Isn't that funny? Farmers only.
Yeah, I know. Yeah.
Yeah.
Are there others that you recommend to your clients, or do you just kind of leave that open to them and allow them to come back to you, or how does that work?
It kind of depends on the person, and I do have a personal favorite, Bumble.
Okay.
It's designed by females, and it's kind of for females, where females make the first move. And my understanding is the women were teamed up with two other men, and they founded Tinder. Did you know that?
No,
I think
not know
that's
that.
My understanding of it. And
right.
They just weren't crazy about how Tinder was
right
going. Uh-huh. So they decided to open up their own app.
Wow.
So it seems to attract some really great quality singles. I've been on it personally.
And why do you think that is? I mean, as far as, is it just because women have to make the first move, or?
I think that has a little to do with it. And it's just like dating apps in general. It's just kind of like whatever is the newest, trendiest app becomes mm-hmm. the most popular one.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
If that makes sense.
Yeah, no, absolutely.
So right now, Bumble is it.
Okay.
Who knows a year from now what it's going to be?
Okay.
That's kind of my take on it.
And when you say, you know, casting your net wide, I mean, do you think it's okay to be? I mean, when I was online dating, mm-hmm. just seeing a certain gentleman on one site and then seeing him on another and another and another, I was like, wow, this guy is really desperate. I mean, is there?
You know, it's I look at it as just. You just never know. You can be on Match. You can be on Bumble. It's really common these days to do that.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the other thing is obviously you wouldn't be doing it if you're in an exclusive relationship. But if you're just dating just to actually meet someone, mm-hmm. it's really common now
right.
to be on a couple apps at the same time. That's not unusual.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do you still find, though, it has weeded out a lot of the married? I mean, I found that there was a lot of married men using the apps as well and were kind of lying about their situation. I mean, is that still pretty?
You know, there always is going to be, unfortunately, a percentage of that. But uh-huh. my thing is get that out of your head.
Right.
Don't even go on an app if that's in your head.
Right. Okay.
Because that's really, it's really negative energy.
Yeah.
Does that make sense?
That totally makes sense.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
that's the expectation then that you're putting out there. Right.
Right. So, yeah. There's yeah. always going to be a percentage of that. But
yeah.
don't, you know, just trust yourself, trust your instinct, and know that there's good guys out there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
yeah. No, I believe that. Do you believe, though, that because of online dating and technology making everything instantly gratifying and information being instantly received, you know, as far as Google goes, do you think that this has an effect on dating?
Yes, unfortunately, it does. It's kind of like everybody is on to the bigger, better deal, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's it has, I think, jaded dating and the psychology of it, where I think some people, there's, you know, some people who they meet someone and they're like, oh, well, you know, the date was fine, but I know I can get someone else right away. And so it's just kind of like that type of, it's kind of like, oh, next.
Yeah, it's like window shopping.
Right.
There's no effort put into even just going on the second date.
Right. So that is it. You're absolutely right. That has made an impact on dating.
Yeah, that's super frustrating. I mean, I know because I've been there before, and there's certain terminology that actually has come out of it, like crumbing, for instance. I mean, are you familiar with crumbing?
No.
just kind of giving you a little bit of pieces each, you know, just a hello, but not letting you go because they may find, you know, someone better, but they may not. And so they want to hold on to you, just kind of keeping you in their portfolio, if you will. So, yeah, all these terminology. But we're going to have to go to a quick break. But when we come back, we will kind of ask Peggy what her online do's and don'ts are. In this segment, The Weekly Skinny, I will be talking about any skin tip that may be current or of news to you or of importance to you. Today, I would like to talk about hot yoga and your skin. I have actually never really been a fan of hot yoga, mainly because I don't drink enough water, but now I have new reasons to add to my list. Studies done recently by dermatologists show that women involved in hot yoga and also spin classes at least 5 times a week were shown to experience more pigmentation and redness in their skin. The research suggests that 30 minutes of exposure to continual heat 3 times a week is enough to change your skin in just 6 weeks. Exposing the skin to heat, not just sun, can increase melanin production through inflammation and deplete the skin of vitamin A, which is an essential vitamin to normalizing DNA, and create free radicals, which in turn lowers antioxidants in the skin and causes wrinkles. You heard it, wrinkles. If you already are suffering from melasma or pigmentation, you may want to avoid or lessen your hot yoga, as well as limit any time in saunas, steam rooms, and hot tubs.
Peach fuzz is great. If it's on a peach, let Sakura Skin & Mind remove unsightly hair with dermaplaning. Although its primary purpose is to remove layers of dead skin, it's just one of the added benefits, leaving your skin baby smooth, safe, effective, fast, and affordable. What a concept! Sakura Skin & Mind wants you to look your very best, and dermaplaning is just one tool in their chest. Find out about dermaplaning at SakuraSkinAndMind.com. S-A-K-U-R-A, SkinAndMind.com. We bring out the healthy skin and healthy way of thinking you didn't know you had.
Hypnotherapy helps you discover and explore deep, sustainable life changes. Let Sakura guide your communication with your unconscious mind. Rid yourself of negative behaviors, fears, pains, and emotions. Weight loss, smoking, childhood trauma, chronic pain, and much more can be addressed. Begin healing now. Just $100 for the first session. Learn more at SakuraSkinAndMind.com. S-A-K-U-R-A, Skin and Mind. Bring out the healthy way of thinking you didn't know you had.
Did you know that your skin is your body's first defense against disease and infection? BrioTech knows and has developed their topical skin spray to enhance your skin's natural healing responses and defenses. BrioTech is all about providing its customers products that help promote skin wellness. BrioTech topical skin spray is a light misting spray free of added fragrance, oil, alcohol, and parabens. All this protection without clogging your pores. It's a must addition to your all-around daily skincare regimen. Try BrioTech, a collection of sprayers from 2 ounces to 8 ounces. With this bundle, you can have BrioTech topical skin spray wherever life takes you. All natural and safe to use from head to toe. Irritations, redness, post-procedure sensitivities? Get BrioTech topical skin spray today. Years in the making, doctor recommended, and available through Amazon. Learn more at BrioTechUSA.com. That's BrioTechUSA.com. Support your skin at BrioTechUSA.com.
Your skin is your body's largest organ. Care for it properly, starting with your face. Sakura Skin & Mind offers several clinical facial treatments to help stimulate collagen production, eliminate toxins, boost circulation, and deeply cleanse. See a new you in your mirror. Clinical facials range from $90 and up. Do your face a favor. Sakura Skin & Mind, erasing wrinkles, one clinical facial at a time. Learn more. SakuraSkinAndMind.com. S-A-K-U-R-A SkinAndMind.com.
Alternative Talk 1150. Local talk for the body, mind, and soul.
Little time to think things over.
Welcome back to Love from the Hip. I am your host, Sakura Sutter. And today I am interviewing Peggy Bennett, who's a clarity love coach, a podcast host of Real Souls with Peggy Bennett, and founder and chief matchmaker of Straight to the Heart. And we're jumping right back into our interview with her, and we're right into the do's and don'ts of online dating. So what are some advice that you have for men and women on online dating?
So online dating, I think, is a great platform for those singles that haven't been in the dating world for a long time. For instance, if they were married for many years and recently divorced, it is great. Great idea to get online just to get some dating practice.
Okay.
Yeah,
that
so
makes sense.
Yeah. Because you're going to be nervous, and it's just a good way to get back into it.
Kind of building your confidence.
Exactly. Right? Exactly. Yeah. So the dating don'ts.
Is that longer than the dating do's? I mean,
so I'm such a visual person, and so the first thing that comes to mind are pictures. Okay.
Yes, please. Can we talk about pictures, please? Can we talk about the bathroom selfie? I mean, really, are you advocating for that, or what's your feeling on that?
Oh, it drives me crazy.
Okay, thank you.
So that, and then the men with posing with the fish.
Oh yes,
you're always going to see that. And I figured out why. It's because a lot of men don't have really a lot of pictures of themselves, and they are so proud of those fish they caught. And so they actually have, you know,
it represents their manhood. Yeah.
It's actually a picture that they have of themselves.
Oh, wow. So yeah. It's probably the only picture. Yeah. Right? I can get that. Because do you really want to date a man that has a ton of selfies, anyways? I
mean, right. Does right.
Say something about them.
So do take your time, guys, on just taking some pictures. And also smile for the guys.
Yes.
It's so funny that they look kind of sometimes pissed off or
super
angry.
Serious.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I don't know if they're trying to have that stud attitude look or what. But anyway, smile. Look approachable in your pictures. And run it by, a female friend of yours or whatever. Mm-hmm. What do you think of these pictures? Because sometimes it's hard to look objectively at your own photos.
And what about women with fish lips? Can we talk about that too, since we're on the topic of fish? Let's just go there.
I know. So ladies, really ask yourself before you go online, what's your intentional goal? Do you want to just have fun, or do you want to actually have a relationship?
Yeah.
And again, really look at those pictures and what are they conveying?
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. That makes a lot of sense.
Yeah.
I mean, and you're really attracting, like you said, what you're putting out there.
Yes.
So, and I would say, I mean,
those are your first impressions.
Yeah, exactly. That's your calling card right there, right?
Definitely. So, definitely.
Yeah, for sure. And I also wonder, too, about people that post a lot of pictures of activities that they don't even do anymore.
Oh.
You know, and then they list all those activities that they maybe tried once.
Right.
I mean, do you find that to be, I find that to be an issue.
Keep updated photos.
Yes, photos.
Keep them up to date. Yes.
It's okay to age. It really is.
Exactly.
Just age well.
And we are only human in that we look at the photos a lot. More than we read the words, right?
Mm-hmm.
We're scanning photos. Both men and women are just as visual.
Oh, okay.
Just remember that. But yes, keep everything really current.
Yeah.
And really think about what message are you sending out. Right.
So I would imagine then, as being a matchmaker, there's got to be some sort of intuitive part about it. I mean, would you call yourself an intuitive matchmaker?
I do. I feel like I am. I'm that's one of the reasons why I love what I do. I love people. I've always been in the people business. If it wasn't for matchmaking, like prior, I was at Nordstrom for 20 years. I just love that one-on-one relationship. And I interview people, but I take into consideration their values, their common lifestyles. But it's also that what you can't get online is looking at their feeling, their energy and their personality, whether they're introvert, extrovert.
Mm-hmm.
So I take all that into consideration.
And also versus online dating, it's like you have their best interest at heart.
Right.
You know, so it's it's way better than
right.
online dating.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah.
Right.
So you're kind of a friend, if you will.
Yes, yeah. definitely.
So what is your ideal man like? And have you met him? Or are you too busy matching everyone else in this city?
Well, I have to say, fortunately, I have met someone recently, so far so good. But he's
awesome.
He's smart, sexy, just sweet. He's just really respectful. We have tons of fun together.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, it's a nice surprise. Just the way we met is kind of a funny story. But you never know until. You just never know. And
well,
that's...
see, now you have to share with us
oh, God.
How you met him, if it's a funny story. Either.
Well, it's just kind of the turn of events. How it happened was back in Thanksgiving.
Uh-huh.
We were on an online site.
Okay.
and we had two dates together. Uh-huh. And at the second date, he called me. And which I loved instead of texting.
Oh,
and,
yes.
And he
please.
Called me and he said, you know, I just have to say that I really like you, but it's just not a good time for me. I just broke up with someone.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
And so
he's honest.
He's really honest.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, it's something I said. I did something wrong.
We're women, right?
So I totally internalized it.
Yes, absolutely.
And it was
fault.
My fault.
Right. Exactly. It's the way I had my hair that day.
So,
I know it was.
So, and then, so the beginning of May, he reaches out and he says, so I don't know if you still remember me, but do you want to meet for a drink? And so we met for a drink and we've been seeing each other ever since.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah.
That's
so he honestly, he really liked me
uh-huh.
Back in Thanksgiving, but he just didn't feel ready. It was just too soon after his breakup.
Which is what you were saying with your clients. You want to make sure that they're ready.
Right.
Right?
And I totally respected the fact that he was so honest.
Yeah. Not many people do that.
Right.
Both,
and actually took the time.
Yeah, exactly. It's very respectful.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can appreciate
so he
that.
Scored points
yeah,
right away.
Yeah, that's a lot of brownie
right?
points. That's really good. Do you, so speaking of successful stories, do you have a successful story with your clients that you can share with us?
Yes. One fun one, which is kind of outside the box, is one of my coaching members of Straight to the Heart, I coached her on how to manifest your soulmate. So we did this whole course
uh-huh.
and she was a member at Straight to the Heart. And also I let her know and encouraged her to be on an online dating app Match at the same time. And so we went through this whole exercise. It took, gosh, I don't know, maybe 5-6 weeks at the time. And she ended up meeting someone. And then they asked me to actually get ordained to marry them.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
So you ended up marrying them, too.
I ended up marrying them on Valentine's Day.
Is that part of your package? Do you offer that service as
I
well?
I can. I'm officially
I think
ordained.
You should.
Yeah, so they got married on Valentine's Day.
Oh,
yes.
How romantic.
Mm-hmm,
that's
mm-hmm.
incredible. That's
but
great.
She went through the whole entire coaching program together.
Yeah, so day mm-hmm. one to, wow.
Right.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
Wow. Excellent. Well, Peggy, we're coming to the end here, but I want to ask you how folks can find you.
Oh, sure. So my podcast, which you mentioned, is Real Souls with Peggy Bennett. So listen and subscribe to that. And then you can also reach me at straighttotheheart.net. That's a website where you can, there's a page for gals and there's a page for guys, and you can register in that. And then that bumps it. The registration to me, and then we can schedule a time to meet in person.
Awesome. Well, thank you very much. Thanks for coming on
oh,
and sharing with
you.
The listeners. Yeah, I
thank
appreciate
you.
It.
My pleasure.
Well, we're going to take a quick break, and when we come back, we're going to actually be following up with Alex from her hypnotherapy session a few weeks ago on lovefromthehip.com.
To change this lonely life.
that your skin is your body's first defense against disease and infection? BrioTech knows, and has developed their topical skin spray to enhance your skin's natural healing responses and defenses. BrioTech is all about providing its customers products that help promote skin wellness. BrioTech Topical Skin Spray is a light misting spray, free of added fragrance, oil, alcohol, and parabens. All this protection without clogging your pores. It's a must addition to your all-around daily skincare regimen. Try BrioTech, a collection of sprayers from 2 ounces to 8 ounces. With this bundle, you can have BrioTech Topical Skin Spray wherever life takes you. All natural and safe to use from head to toe. Irritations, redness, post-procedure sensitivities? Get BrioTech Topical Skin Spray today. Years in the making, doctor recommended, and available through Amazon. Learn more at BrioTechUSA.com. That's BrioTechUSA.com. Support your skin at BrioTechUSA.com.
If you're planning on building a home or a major landscaping project, you'll want the team of Stone Resources on your side. Safely, effectively, and correctly working with our unique terrain requires local knowledge and environmental care. For 21 years, Stone Resources has been making sure their customers' biggest investment is on solid ground. Trust your next earth-moving project to Stone Resources. Call 425-754-6792. That's 425-754-6792. Stone Resources. We make the earth move. And remember, if you need dirt or have dirt to get rid of, you can call on us. 425-754-6792.
Microneedling is a revolutionary treatment that can help reduce the appearance of acne scars, fine lines, pigmentation, wrinkles, even improve the appearance of stretch marks by stimulating collagen and elastin. Sakura Skin and Mind specializes in this procedure that jumpstarts your body's natural healing process. Sakura Skin and Mind believes in not only keeping the skin up to date with the latest trends in the skincare industry, but also keeping the skin beautiful, fast, pretty, painless, and affordable. Find out more at SakuraSkinAndMind.com. S-A-K-U-R-A SkinAndMind.com.
Men, care for your skin properly, starting with your face. Sakura Skin and Mind offers their Gentleman's Groom Clinical Facial for just $120. Designed for your rugged skin, a deep cleansing clinical facial is like a 1-2-3 punch to wrinkles, age spots, and problem skin. Tame those brows, ears, and nostrils. Sakura Skin and Mind, erasing wrinkles one clinical facial at a time. Learn more at SakuraSkinAndMind.com. S-A-K-U-R-A skinandmind.com.
Bored with the other stations hammering away on the same old talking points? Try Alternative Talk 1150 and get some variety.
Come on inside. Welcome back to Love from the Hip, and I'm your host, Sakura Sutter. And today we're following up with Alex, and actually Jody. And I had hypnotized Alex a few weeks ago, and you can find that session at lovefromthehip.com. So Alex was brave enough to allow me to hypnotize her for the issue of not trusting others due to having been sexually abused at a very young age by a very close relative. I was one of the few people whom Alex has ever spoken to about it in hopes of getting therapy through hypnotherapy to get through it and help herself. Alex also wanted to share her story publicly, yet in the most discreet way, in hopes of helping others, too, that have been in similar circumstances, but have been too afraid to confront it. She is a kind and wonderful soul for wanting to divulge such a secret she held on to for 18 years, and for wanting to relive such a scary past in order to help others today. Hello, Alex. Hello, Jody.
Hey.
So just to recap for listeners, Alex, that have not listened to your session, was this the first time you were hypnotized?
It was.
Okay.
Definitely.
And what were your concerns about being hypnotized?
I was just really concerned about not being able to remember, just thinking that it wouldn't really change in the slightest.
Okay. And so what were your fears about being hypnotized?
My fears is I would just start talking, just start rambling, not understand what was going on.
Mm-hmm.
I definitely did, though.
I was going to say, so, I mean, how did it feel. I know it's kind of a little bit harder to explain, but for people that have never been hypnotized before, what would you say to them?
Well, first, it was a great experience. Thank you so much. Being hypnotized, I didn't expect to feel such a, I wouldn't say change, but such a deep feeling. Mm-hmm. So when you had me under, I was feeling very relaxed. Mm-hmm. I wasn't expecting that. I was still expecting to be very tense.
Okay.
You know,
yeah,
I just,
and despite being in the studio, you were able to relax.
Yeah, at one point, I didn't even think I was in the studio. So when I came back up, I was kind of like, where am I for a second?
Wow, okay. And how are you feeling today?
I'm feeling good. I feel a little less weight on my shoulders.
Mm-hmm.
Me and Jody are doing really great.
Okay.
Very happy together.
Yeah.
What are the
changes that you've noticed?
You know, I actually had a little, I would say like a little trust kind of test. my thing is it's hard to trust whether someone says something to me. It's very hard for me to trust. But I actually had an incident where she went over.
Jody?
Yes, Jody, my girlfriend. Went over to a friend's house and I didn't have a reaction. I just let her have her time. I just enjoyed that she was having a good time.
How would you normally react?
Oh, I would have texted her a whole bunch of things, been mad, been worried, just angry, mad for no reason.
Wow. And how long ago was this?
I would say it was a couple days after the hypnotist.
A couple weeks?
Yeah.
Okay.
No, a couple days.
A couple days.
Yeah,
I'm sorry.
So you did it. Yeah. And it was like about 3 days after.
Oh, wow. Okay. All right. And Jody, what have you noticed about Alex?
You know, every day is different, but I think what's been constant since the hypnotherapy, she's somehow like gotten to take it with her every day. And it's either in her conscious or subconscious. She tries to relax herself before she really reacts to something, I've noticed.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah.
So she's not as reactive as she was before.
Yeah, she's more like in a thought process before the reaction.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. And how long after did you notice that change in her?
Like probably also after that incident, but just kind of daily things every day, you know, there's something different that mm-hmm. comes about. So
yeah,
how she reacts is important. Yeah.
That's wonderful. I mean, have you noticed also how you're thinking, that process? Has it changed?
I am. It's definitely changed mainly with Jody. With other human beings, it's still a work in progress.
Right.
I still
got strangers. Right?
Oh, yes, yeah. Definitely. That will be a work in progress. But uh-huh. with Jody, it seems to be a little less. I'm not so questioning. I'm just relaxed.
Okay. That's good. That's good. And has anyone else around you, aside from Jody, noticed any changes in you?
You know, I haven't asked anybody. Mm-hmm. I'm pretty sure some of my coworkers probably did. Not so angry at work or not so jumpy at work.
Right.
But I haven't asked. And
they probably appreciate
it. Oh, absolutely.
Well, and a lot of times, I mean, I know I didn't get to explain a lot of how hypnotherapy works and what the process is like, and just explaining to people that you're not in an unconscious state. I'm not knocking you out, and that you're fully aware of what you're saying and you remember mm-hmm. what you say. But also to know that when you go through hypnosis, you're actually not just shifting yourself. Because you're shifting yourself, people around you are changing as well.
Mm-hmm.
So it actually helps all of your relationships
That's
without
crazy.
Them even having to go to therapy with you, which
That's
is incredible,
crazy.
Right?
Yeah.
So, I mean, did you have questions? Because I didn't get to go there with you.
I did. How long have you been doing this?
I've actually been a spiritual hypnotherapist for 5 years.
Oh, wow.
And studied at Bastyr University.
That's cool.
So aside from other practices that I have been certified in as mm-hmm. well, which I also did a little bit of neuro-linguistic programming with you, too, just kind of with
wow.
the mirror that we brought out in our session. So, and
Definitely.
Any other?
Yeah. How long, I mean, now that we've had a session together, mm-hmm. how long do you think, or how many times, I guess, do you think I would need to continue,
great.
Yeah.
Great question. So everyone is different. As far as how many you need, I can't tell you right here, right now. But I think that the more that you do it, you will know.
Definitely.
I mean, and the fact that things are still, mm-hmm. you know, as far as your relationships with everyday people, mm-hmm. which I would imagine would be a lot tougher because, I mean, you don't know them. So why would you trust them? And even just the regular person, has issues of trust with that. So it varies on the person as to how many sessions you need. Mm-hmm. But I feel like the more you will do it, because you have other issues, right? We all have a ton of issues. So we're kind of conquering each issue at a time, right?
Definitely.
Yeah.
So. I did want to say it was crazy after the session. I wasn't like numb, but I was just very sleepy.
Uh-huh.
And then I went home and just fell asleep for about 8 to 9 hours and I was just out.
Yeah, well, you did a lot of work.
Yes.
I mean, you really did. And to be in that situation and to go through trauma itself, I mean, mm-hmm. you're having to relive that. And so, of course, you're going to be exhausted.
Definitely.
I mean, it's basically going through the whole experience all over again. And I know we had to be very discreet with the audience and whatnot.
Definitely.
But yeah, just having to go through that again was, you know. You did a really good job.
Thank you.
And I know that was your first time ever. Thank you. I know that was your first time ever being hypnotized. So
it was.
Yeah.
It was an experience. I would definitely do it again.
Good. Awesome.
Absolutely.
And so any other questions? Jody, do you have any questions?
I'm just really happy that she actually took that opportunity. So that it was like just a way for her to open up and heal for herself. It was a great opportunity.
Yeah. And she did a really good job. And she's just excited to do it. And I think it works better for people that are open and ready.
Yes.
So,
yes.
Well, I thank you both for being here.
Thank you. Definitely.
Yeah. And I know, and I appreciate all your hard work and I look forward to working more with you.
Absolutely.
And yeah. And just remember I said, be kind to yourself and be patient. You know, a lot of things took time to be there.
Mm-hmm.
And so it will take a little bit of time to unlearn that behavior.
Definitely.
So, yeah.
So thank you so much.
You. Yeah. So we are out of time for today, but I would like to thank Alex again and Jody, and also thank Eric, my amazing producer, and you, the listener. And you can find me at lovefromthehip.com or sakuraskinandmind.com. Also, please like me on Facebook at Love From The Hip and follow me on Instagram at Love From The Hip, and that's HYP. And if you are interested in being hypnotized in my clinic and sharing your experience on the air or have questions or comments, please email me at sakura@lovefromthehip.com or call 206-730-7429. And tune in next Wednesday at 2 p.m. and make self-love contagious. Go ahead. I dare you. In this weekly segment of Get Hip, I will be talking about an experience with a client with hypnotherapy as well as other mind modalities in my clinic and how it has helped them. Today, you heard me follow up with Alex, and I again encourage you to listen to her hypnotherapy session at lovefromthehip.com. Although I had to leave out some details to protect my guest as well as having to be discreet with you, the listener, I was still able to have Alex relive the narrative as scary as it is. And although it has been her narrative, she had disassociated from it for obvious reasons and therefore also disassociated from herself. But by externalizing the experience and seeing it objectively versus subjectively, it helped to redefine her experience. And now it is the process of reintegrating that into her life and changing her brain chemistry in the process, which you have heard she has already started to do. And yes, it may take Alex more sessions to overcome this trauma completely, especially with triggers unbeknownst to her, but she has already started to shift in a more positive direction, and that is what matters.
Your skin is your body's largest organ. Care for it properly, starting with your face. Sakura Skin and Mind offers several clinical facial treatments to help stimulate collagen production, eliminate toxins, boost circulation, and deeply cleanse. See a new you in your mirror. Clinical facials range from $90 and up. Do your face a favor. Sakura Skin and Mind, erasing wrinkles, one clinical facial at a time. Learn more, sakuraskinandmind.com. SakuraSkinandMind.com.
Did you know that your skin is your body's first defense against disease and infection? BrioTech knows and has developed their topical skin spray to enhance your skin's natural healing responses and defenses. BrioTech is all about providing its customers products that help promote skin wellness. BrioTech topical skin spray is a light misting spray free of added fragrance, oil, alcohol, and parabens. All this protection without clogging your pores.
It's a must addition to your all-around daily skincare regimen. Try BrioTech, a collection of sprayers from 2 ounces to 8 ounces. With this bundle, you can have BrioTech topical skin spray wherever life takes you. All natural and safe to use from head to toe. Irritations, redness, post-procedure sensitivities? Get BrioTech topical skin spray today. Years in the making, doctor recommended, and available through Amazon. Learn more at BrioTechUSA.com. That's BrioTechUSA.com. Support your skin at BrioTechUSA.com.
Peach fuzz is great, if it's on a peach. Let Sakura Skin & Mind remove unsightly hair with dermaplaning. Although its primary purpose is to remove layers of dead skin, it's just one of the added benefits, leaving your skin baby smooth, safe, effective, fast, and affordable. What a concept! Sakura Skin & Mind wants you to look your very best, and dermaplaning is just one tool in their chest. Find out about dermaplaning at SakuraSkinAndMind.com. S-A-K-U-R-A, SkinAndMind.com. We bring out the healthy skin and healthy way of thinking you didn't know you had.